The manager spoke last week about the team needing a big game to give them that edge back after a bit of a lull for a few weeks. Obviously, after the result of the weekend there, do you feel that you've got that edge back ahead of a couple of big games this week?
Yeah, as you say, there's probably no bigger game than the one last weekend, just past there. I think the boys were fantastic in the game, and obviously the most important thing was the result, and we managed to get that.
Scott, when you look at this week, the same opposition in two consecutive games, and they are obviously on a good streak. Is this actually quite a dangerous week for Rangers, given the unbeaten run and what you're hoping to keep in the Scottish Cup?
Every game is obviously massive at a club like this, so we'll go into the game with the same mindset for everyone. We want to win every game, obviously. And as you say, St Johnstone are on a good run at the minute, and obviously they've had the cup success earlier in the season, so no, I'm sure it'll be a good game.
Scott, obviously since you've come into the team, you've had a few appearances off the bench and a few starts as well. Is this the kind of game that you can really excel in, put a mark down and then perhaps start it in the bigger games in the Scottish Cup going forwards?
Yeah, I've said before that I want to try and make an impact on the team, whether that's coming on from the bench or whether it's starting. And obviously all I can try and do is give the manager something to think about, whether that's from the start or whether that's making an impact from the bench.
Just picking up from that, does it give you guys a lot of confidence that you are going to get that chance? Because the manager's constantly saying about how it's a squad game and he wants to give you all a chance.
Yeah, definitely. We've got a good squad. Obviously at a club like this, there's so many games, whether that's through Europa League or obviously now the Scottish Cup as well. There's going to be so many games, so you're going to need to obviously utilise the squad, and I think whoever's came in has done a good job, and I think it's obviously on the players to make sure that they give the manager something to think about to be put in, and then once you're put in, it's the sake of trying to grab your chance.
Hey Scott, I mean obviously that's the team through the quarterfinals of the Scottish Cup now. I mean you've potentially got a big day at Hampden next month to look forward to if you can sort of keep on going through the competition. Is that something that's really driving your competition for places? You have to even want a cup final slot if you can get there?
Yeah, it's always important to keep pushing ourselves. The mantra here is not to stand still. It's always to keep moving. And as I say, with such a big squad, there's always competition for places. So if you kind of come off it a wee bit, there's going to be somebody waiting to try and take your spot. So if you get that shirt, it's a sake of trying to keep it and make it your own.
Just on that, Scott, I mean, obviously coming towards the end of your season here and when you join, how have you found your impact at Rangers? Are you happy with where you are now at the club moving forward on to the next season? And how much do you think you've grown at the time you've joined Rangers?
Yeah, I think I've probably played a little bit more than I was expecting to. I thought it was kind of come in and get my face in the door and kind of get used to the tactics and the boys and the management. Obviously, it's such a big change, but I'm probably personally delighted with how far it's gone so quick. And as I say, it's a sake of keep moving forward, not standing still, and going to chase down the next target.
Scott, we're hearing a lot about this European Super League that's dominating the conversation. Obviously, when you signed for Rangers, one of your ambitions would have been to play in the Champions League. How, as a footballer, do you feel about this when you see these plans being drawn up?
It's obviously all quite up in the air, and you only hear bits and pieces through the news and on TV. So I'm still obviously trying to take it in and kind of get some of the facts, and I've obviously got friends messaging me about it as well. So it's certainly an interesting one to see, and I'm not sure obviously how good for football it will be or how bad for football it will be, but it's certainly an interesting one. So I'm interested to see kind of what else is going to come out about it and have a look into it there.